Get the hell out of there. I said the same thing for South Chicago and probably now in parts of New York. Look at this poor bastard. He wanted to get rich or set up Airbnb. And the Soviet Socialist State of Southern California said to the tenant, you can stay in there for free. We won't kick you out. And the excuse they're using is some kind of zoning violation, which is just horse hockey, in my opinion, as far as that goes. The Airbnb renter is now dubbed as she apparently refuses to leave the multi-million dollar rental in Los Angeles. This is not a new story, however. During the pandemic, certain states, same aforementioned state, did not evict people. What's that like? What do you think that's like for a family that saved up their money, bought a property, fixed it up so they could provide housing for somebody else? And then that person decides, I'm not going to pay because we have a pandemic. I had a bad day. My wife doesn't understand me. I had a bad job. I lost my job. I should live in your house that you worked for free. Okay. You guys know where I'm coming. What do you guys think on this? You're going to let.
Sure beats living on the street.
Well, yeah, that's interesting you said that, Tim, because I have another thing here. If I can find it, I hope I can find it. Oh, yes, here it is. Let's see if I can bring that up. Get rid of this one. Give me a second here. Got another article. Really, right on top, Tim, you're right on top of stuff, buddy. That's exactly the article I want to share with you here. Let me get the other, admit the other people here. Did you guys see this article? ABC News. Nearly a third. Can you guys see the screen? Raise your hand or nod your head or something. Nearly a third of U.S. homeless population lives in California. Here's why. Do we need to read the article to know why? Okay. And I don't think it's, it's come to a point where is anyone keeping this in a business type conversation? I know we're all sympathetic and stuff like that. But do you think it gets to a point where if you're too tolerant or socially conscious, I'm very careful with my words today, that you're going to see the decimation of city neighborhoods and no more investing? What do you guys think about this? Are people going to stop investing in neighborhoods that the crime is high or there's a lot of people living on the street and feces and garbage and thing? I mean, is anyone going to invest in that neighborhood and pay taxes so you can have schools and fire departments and hospitals and things like that? What's going to happen to those neighborhoods? Argue with me, somebody. Tell me I'm wrong. I'll listen. I'll respect your opinion. You guys
all no argument here, Bob.
But this is what's going on in parts of our country, and today's topic is real estate dead. I want to talk about it. Is it dead? It's not dead, but in certain areas, it's on life support. In my opinion, I base my opinion on would I invest in certain neighborhoods? Would I invest in San Francisco right now?